John Stuart Mill. I stand here to represent the importance of thinking and acting. But first, a story. I was born in London on May 20th, 1806. My father over my life has taught me a lot of important subjects, including but not limited to history, mathematics, logic, and political economy. By the time I was 14, I had an excellent understanding of both Greek and Latin. At the time, I had traveled to France to continue my studies. Later, I took up a job with East India Company in 1823 and stayed there until 1858. At around the age of 20, I had a nervous breakdown, which now that I look back at it, is probably a side effect of my vigorous desire to learn. I soon recovered thanks to the poetry of William Wordsworth and used his work with a combination of other sources to utilize a step towards Greek. In 1865, I was elected to be a member of the Parliament of Westminster, where I remained for 3 years. During the same period, I also served as the rector of the renowned University of St. Andrews. I was very proactive and worked to implement reforms towards proportional representation and labor unions and supported women's rights. I was the first parliamentary representative to support women's right to vote and was a co-founder of the first women's suffrage organization. I only became known as a philosopher in 1843, and in the same year I published System of Logic, Ratio Synthesis, and Inductive, my most systematic work. In 1848, I published Principles of Political Economy, which may concern the most important text of my time. My book examines the conditions of production, mainly labor and nature. Following Ricardo Malthus, it emphasized the possibility of change in social improvement and examines environmental protection needs. However, in order for these to be obtained, I considered a limitation of both economic and population, as the polis itself is indispensable. One of my main trajectories in that course of democratization is that there always is a danger of the tyranny of the majority. This is a danger one cannot be protected from, even though the majority might be wrong. In general, such liberty is only applicable and possible for those who are able to decide for themselves. Therefore, such a notion excludes children and those I would even go so far as to call barbarians. My examination of Sir William Hamilton's philosophy is said to contain the first appearance of the belief that our knowledge is limited to the realities present that our senses use. It was only after my paper was published that my work became the standard among scientific philosophers at the time. Co-written with my wife, the subjection of women is quite thorough for its time and yet caused another controversy. My essay argued in favor of equality of the sexes, employing utilitarian arguments. I am convinced that the inequality of women would impede human progress in general. For myself, the only way to find out whether there are actually differences